cancers of the head and neck. How often do you see these kind of patients?
We typically see maybe about one a month, one every two weeks or so.
So it's less common.
It's less common. I think it's just because our practice is better known for breast cancer reconstruction. More of them come to us, but we still do see a number of other type of cancers as well.
And how much of a difference is there in terms of the reconstruction here? Like, let's talk about maybe the jaw area. You do that, correct?
Yes, that's correct.
Okay, what kind of reconstructive surgery does that entail?
Well, typically these are a lot more functional effective, right? Meaning that if you have cancer of the jaw and someone removes a piece of your jaw with the skin, that you need reconstruction. Mm-hmm. There's no way you can just be left without a jaw or just having a hole in this area. In fact, actually, when I was a medical student, my mentor gave us a lecture on this, and this is sort of what drove me into plastic surgery. The most common way to sort of reconstruct this is if they're missing a large piece of jaw, is using a bone from your leg, taking the blood vessels from there and reconnecting it to recreate that bone so that way you can get the shape and the strength back. So that way in the future you can eat. I remember as a medical student, I was thinking, wow, this guy's like MacGyver of doctors. He's like making a jaw out of a leg.
That's amazing.
Yeah. And so, you know, that's one of the main what we call workhorses in terms of what we would do in terms of if you had part of your jaw taken away because of cancer.
And what is the recovery of something like that? Does one need to learn not only the pain, for the love of God, but to learn how to chew again? Is there pain with that as well?
There is going to be pain with that for sure. It's going to be a significant higher amount of pain. You would be in the hospital for about a week, sometimes a little bit longer.
Oh, wow. Really?
Yes. Because especially when it becomes that large of a cancer involving your jaw, you would also sometimes, depending on what the cancer surgeon does, you might need to have what's called a tracheostomy, meaning that having a tube in your throat to help you breathe because all the swelling and things like that. And you probably won't be able to eat until a while later, until that bone takes and it heals and sort of grows back. So that recovery process is significantly longer. I'm not going to say harder, but it's going to be longer and sort of more challenges for you to go through.